Hello everyone, my name is Oli. I like to share this little tutorial video about Age of Wonders 3. This is a very nice game. This is one of the best of the recent years about turn-based strategies. Let's look inside the game. Let's hit this new random map. There are some scenarios around, but we like the random map here. Let's see, let's hit this advanced settings button, and the normal settings are here as well, so don't worry. And we got some other adjustable things we should like to adjust. Let's see the difficulty. The Lord is the normal one, so you are as same strong as the enemy, so I recommend this or Knight for beginners. Let's see the map size. Well, that means how big are land masses, and well, I truly recommend medium or large, because the extra large, even the game says this is very long time to compete, so I recommend large or maybe medium. Let's see our land type. This is very important. How much water you want. It should be land, continents or islands. I truly like the land, but don't worry if you set more water. There will be some enemies there, so you not feel lacking for any enemy. Okay, but I just don't like going around in the water, that's all. Let's see our next adjustable thing. There are two levels in the game. Usually, if we set these two on, that means we got a surface and the underground as well. But if you don't like one of them, like you don't like underground, you should pick one and switch it off. You cannot switch off both, but that's normal because you have to have a map somewhere. So I recommend use both. There are places where you can go to the other. All right, let's see on right side here. The starting town, I recommend settler. That's where you should go and settle your first town, wherever you wish, and I truly recommend you do that, because this is the right way. Let's see our starting units. Well, if you look inside, we should choose weak, medium, strong or better. I truly recommend not choose weak or better. The medium is fine, or strong is fine as well. You got a little stronger unit, but the other two is too weak or too overwhelming, so I truly not recommend it. Alright, let's see our next one, starting distance. I recommend this, keep far, because you don't want to hop on the enemy right away, or you just have to set a small map and you should jump the enemy right away, so you don't have to choose a large map if your starting distance is near, right? Alright, let's see, the road is fine. You don't need to touch it. Roaming units, this is which is a very crucial switch here, because the roaming units try to be a little rise of the game sometimes, so some random units are hopping to your backyard and you have to take care of it. This is not a bad idea, but this is absolutely random which units you get. So when we second time we met most strong units in our backyard, we just decided we don't want this anymore. So I truly recommend switches off completely. Let's see our next one is treasure. Well, I like average or many, how many gold or mana stash lying around, so you have to be quick and gather it all. Let's see our next one, cities. This is an important one, because if you set this average or many, you may even not need to go out settle new cities. Instead, you should go to conquer the neighborhood natural cities, or you should diplomatically ask them to join you. So that's the way. I like this average or many, so I don't have to settle every minute, so this is a very nice addition to the game. Let's see this dwelling. This is special cities around the world, usually 2, 3, or even 5. I think I saw 5 of them. That means some special villages around, like fairies or dragons or giants and so on. This cannot be a starter race, but this is just a small race. You go there and take away their cities diplomatically or conquer it, I don't care, but when this is yours, you should build some building in it and build some special units in it. So this is a very nice one. You should build dragons, which is the strongest units in the game. So if you like this possibility, you should go with average or many or few, but I don't recommend to switch it off them. Let's see our next one, resource structures. Well, this is an important one. So how many gold mines or some kind of resource giving structures around. I like many, but average is good. I not recommend to go under average. The physics structures is not important. I don't mind which you should choose, but the treasure structures, this is very important. How many dungeons around? We like many. That's all. Let's go to the next screen. Yes, we set 5 player. We got 1 player and 4 computer player. All set to our settings. We set this lord, but we should change here manually. However, we even changed that computer to human, so we got a hot seat game here. So this is very nice possibility, and even if we could set that we should team each other and go against a very strong enemy. So this is a very nice one. Alright, let's switch this back now. Okay, and let's see what possibilities there yet. The classic turns, this is the favor, this is the normal turn based. Possible, the simultan turn, this is a very odd one, so I don't really like, because I just saw there goes the enemy, but I don't see anymore. What kind of game is this? I don't like that. But the classic turn, this is the normal one. This is very nice. Let's see our next one, customized leader. This is an important one. You always have a customized leader. You want to go with you really want to. So you should choose some predefined leaders, but I don't recommend it. Let's build your leader. We'll see it later. Or you should choose leader if you already have a customized leader from earlier. Alright, the tactical combatant against humans or AI. Usually we want to do a normal combat, so we don't like quick combat. Who knows what the computer is doing there. Alright, let's hit this advanced rules button. This contains a very interesting switches. Let's see the first one, map exploration. This is an important one. If you switch this off, the whole map reveals from the beginning, so you don't have to go exploring the map just because you have to exploring the map, but you should go gather the stash around. The city's founding, I not recommend to switch it off, because that way you cannot able to found cities, so that's not nice. The other is this not important. The fourth one is very, very important, because normally when you go to the battle, you got a nice animation, at least first or second time. But later on, I don't want to watch animations. I really want to go to the battle. So we're very glad when we find this little switch here. So this animation goes off, goes a few moments and gone. The Empire quest is do as you wish with it, and this is not so important. Let's see our little but maybe this is a good one, so I don't recommend to switch it off. You should get some goals when you go against the map, so if you do something first, you usually got some reward for it. So if you want to know about this, you should check the Wikipedia, this game's Wikipedia, of course. Alright, the game speed, that's normal. I recommend not to touch it, but if you want a slower or faster game, go ahead. The starting resource, well, how much gold and some other things you get. This is, I truly recommend standard or high. The low or very high is not fair, either of them. The starting skills, this is an important one. Let's just say, if you choose many, you can start with empty-handed the map, but the normal is fine, the few is hurting, and the none is, well, you don't have anything, so you have to use sheer power. I don't know about that. I recommend normal or many. Let's see the next one. All heroes have resurgence. Well, if you want to cheat, then go ahead, but I recommend never. The next one is a crucial one. If you are a beginner player, never even think to touch this, because it said normal or higher, and this is where I guess the game is lacking a little bit, because there should be an easy and some stage between the normal and strong, but this is just my opinion. Let's just say the strong is really strong, so even the gold mine became challenging, but the very strong is almost not playable, so I not recommend to anyone. Let's see our next one, cosmic happenings. This is a very influencing thing, so I truly recommend not go higher than easy. You should switch it off, but we don't really want to switch it off, because it gave us some opportunity. But one thing for sure, if you go with medium or hard, this will cost you a lot of headache, that's for sure. And the last thing here, maximum number of heroes and maximum hero level. This is very important one. I truly recommend not to set the number of heroes to 10, because if you get more heroes, you just find out you get some groups around, and this all contains just heroes. So that's not This was nice, though. Use some normal units, please. And the maximum hero level, well, if you are playing a normal game without DLC, I recommend 15. If you got some DLC, I recommend 20. This is a... Because if you set higher, it causes some bug in the game, so please don't do it. Okay, apply and apply and launch the game, but we didn't get to launch the game because here's the time when we could customize our little hero here. Let's see. There are three things we should decide. First, what kind of class we use, what kind of race we have, and what kind of specialization we have. So this could be a very crucial one, what kind of game you want. I truly recommend use the Wikipedia Age of Wonders 3 page, because you can see what kind of possibility you have. If you choose the class, any class, like Rogue or Warlord, there are some nice sheets there. If we got a Warlord unit or a Theocrat unit, so like Martyr or Evangelist, so we will have a Goblin Martyr and a Goblin Evangelist, or an Orc Martyr and Orc Evangelist, and so on. So this a huge amount of playable characters around, and the race has their own unit, so we have a lot of units around, and you should check which class and race you want to play, which units you like the best, or you should go with some class and race combination some way. So I truly recommend to check the Wikipedia Age of Wonders 3 site for this. Alright, let's see what kind of races we got. We got goblins. This is a little weak. It's operate poison mostly, but this is a little weaker than the others. The orc is strong, however, I not recommend it to beginner player, because it mostly rely on the melee combat, and that's not the best in the game, I guess. The best way to kill your opponent is use some nasty archers. The humans is very nice, they got very nice units. Maybe this is a looks empty bonuses, but this city plus this 10 production is not bad. And the high elf is a very nice race, got some really nice bonuses, so you should go with that. Or Tigran is a very favorable class. This is an expansion class, that's why stronger than the other ones, I guess. The Frostling is a tricky one, because this is very usable unless you find an opponent is a fire wizard and you get flanked. Okay, let's see, our halfling is a little tricky one, but playable. And the Draconian are strong, mostly usually playing with fire. The dwarf, this is a slow race, but got a ton of bonus, but through they really higher their cost in any unit, so this is a, you have to go with it. You will expand a little slower, that's why. Let's see our classes here. The most strong is the Theocrat, I guess. Maybe others not agree with me, but Theocrats have so many ways to improve themselves. So once we played, my heroes is just hit the 7th level, and my friend heroes at the 4th. So let's just say they can really improve themselves. So let's see our next class. Before I go further with this is strong all the way. So that's why I really like the Theocrat. Okay, let's see this Archdruid. Well, this is not my favorite. They try to summon some animals and made some tricky spells, but this is not the best, I guess. That's why I don't really like it. The Dreadnought, this is a tricky one. They usually operates with some machines, so maybe this is good because some nasty mind controlling enemy don't have an effect on them, and the necromancers haven't got any effect either. So this is an interesting one. This is some kind of exception about the classes. The necromancer is very strong. This is the newest class, and I just have to say this is a really cruel one. Let's see our next one. The sorcerer is still good because first we got some buggy spells they have, but later this is all repaired, but still strong. They got really nasty magic around, so that's why it's so strong. The rogue is a very interesting one. You should go with it if you want to make a quick game. This is very good, but later falling a little behind because they don't have 4-level units, but you should choose some specialization which got some 4-level units, so that may be not a problem. Alright, let's see our next one is Warlord. This is my favorite, but they got some issues because they weak in the early game, and when they finally research is the extremely amount and terrible Empire upgrades and Empire spells, that will be an incredible cruel class. Alright, we circled around, so let's see our specialization here. We got the normal 4 elemental magic. If we choose one, it's hop on a master of it, so we always got in a magic type 2 possible choices, adept, and if we got one we should choose master 2. That's go with 2 slots, so this is a little expensive, but why we should choose 2? First we got more nice spells, of course, but we usually doing it because it possible after that to transform a mana node into the special node, so this time air node. So we got 5 more research points, and in the beginning of the game this is a very nice bonus, so that's why we usually choose a magic type and go with both adept and master it and choose something else. Let's see what kind of magic we have here. There's the creation and the destruction. I personally much more like the creation because it contains nice unit spells, but the destruction mostly contain some city spells which you should cast on the enemy city or anything. So I don't like to curse the enemy city. I just want to go there and conquer it. So that's why I like creation more. And there are some expander explorer specialization. We like more mostly the expander because that's easier to expand ourselves with it. The explorer one, well, this is a tricky one. I not recommend this beginners. All right, the five last choices: Grey Guard, Keeper of the Peace, and Shadowborn. This is very interesting, and I don't really get why they put that in here. Just I think they just want to do a little more possibility here. I think the Shadowborn, this is a really good one, but none of it I recommend for beginner players. Please choose one of the elemental magic or creation or even destruction, but later you will explore these one as well. Alright, let's see what we should use today. This is too much. Let's see if I choose my favorite. This is the Warlord Dwarf class and race, and for the specialization, let's go with creation and one air. This is a very cruel settings. Alright, let's go next. Yes, we could adjust our little leader, so I don't like this one, so please be a woman. I don't know. So we got our races, we got our classes, and we got our specialization. So let's just hit the button and okay, save the leader. Wanted the shocking. Why shocking? Because they not use shock attack. Alright. So we should save this leader if we want to play with this later. So we just have to choose it from the list, and we don't have to customize again. So when we hit this done button, the computer starting to generate a new world. Let's look inside it. Okay, we finally got our hands on our little world. Let's see what kind of unit we have. Yes, we switch off this one. This just saying what do you have to do in the game. Yes, the hero offered to join. Let's see, an Archduke Druid. I don't really like this one, but alright, please join me. That was 100 gold. We should declined him, but he stayed the same position, and next time we hope on another class, but I will not waiting for that right now. Let's see what kind of structure we have. We got a gold mine here with some draconian units. This is 2 infantry and 1 little hatchling which can fire some or spit some fire for us. A phantasmorial is a medium unit, so this is a tricky one, I guess. This is a mana node, so if we conquer it, we should transform it right away. Let's see our next one. This is a farm, which causes a little more population. That's not bad. Here's another gold mine. Okay, let's look around a little more. Let's choose some units which we can go with it. Oh, something is wrong. May I hit the wrong? No, here it is. Okay. Yes, this is a crossbowman, this is an axeman, this is a deep guard. This is 2 infantry units, so I... Oh, no. Okay, so I grab one and look around with it. Some mana lying there, so thank you. Okay, here's the air node. This is not good for us. The fire node is not good for us too, but no problem. Let's see a little deep guard. Yes, I should use this to explore a little if I able to do it, of course. Aha. Well, this is a refugee camp. In the first turn, please don't pick it up because you don't have a city where the refugees join, so don't be stupid. Okay, let's see what kind of skill we should research. This is no-brainer, we go with Bless, because that's a very nice spell. Okay, this is the gold mine, right? So, where should we settle? I really think it would be here somewhere. Maybe here. This is a little too far, I guess, so... Alright, let's go here and settle. Maybe here. Alright. Okay. So... This gold mine is a little off now, so... I should say we should go to this one and ask them what they want. And this is our first battle. Oh, another gold mine. This will be very profitable for us. So one nice tip, if you want to conquer something, you don't have to go with the entire army. You should go with only one tiny member of it, and every single unit which is near the position where I going and cause the battle will be go inside the battle, so we should even have a 7 place battle, so that's a really huge map, I know, but it should be worth it if you want to make some so if you want to make some advantage. This is a this pony rider is a little strong unit, and this halfling adventurer, well, they shoot at us, so I don't like this, but alright. Let's go into the battle, and let's see why we really like this animation goes. So there is no animation at all, so this is what I'm talking about. You don't have to wait a minute to go into the battle. And there are two possibilities here. First, the enemy will crazy run towards you, and the other, they waiting for you. This is, I guess this is a random setting, so what will happen. Both have benefits us, because if they running, we just hunt them. But if we have to go, they will get the first move. So this is a little trickier for us. Alright, let's see a little. This is our main or the normal magician who is us, represents us. So we should able to use some magic already. If we go to the next one, this is an arch druid, so it can use some tricky spells, but he got the root spears. This is very nice, because this is a direct damage spell. So let's see what which we should use. Yes, this is nice one. The suffocate is nice one too, because this is a normal physical damage spell, but not inflict any damage to mechanical or undead units. So keep it under the control. So let's see what should we do. This is very nice, because we got a dwarf forge priest. It shooted 3 fireballs and even got a healing ability, so I like this unit. And let's see this one. This is a crossbowman, not a strong unit, but he got a one-time shooter heavy crossbow, so let's see if we can go a little further. If you use your right click, you should able to out of range. All right then, I don't care, defend. So you should change the face. Where are you? Which direction are you facing when you use the right button here, as you can see. We just have to grab the unit and try to go that direction, and it's facing that direction. Alright, this is an adventure. Alright, let's just go here. Defend yourself, please. Alright, and this is our main hero here, and why don't we try to spell something. We got 20 mana possibilities, so this is 45% success, but in the Pony Rider it's just only 20, so I tried it. Some halfling adventurer, and it is resisted, however they got some side effects on it. Alright, defend please. Face the defense and click the end turn. Let's see if they're moving, but no. We are not close enough. When we are close enough, they just started to run at us. All right. Why don't we try the some little physical damage? You should use magic only once in a turn, so either you have more spellcaster, that's no matter, you just able to cast once in a turn, so they try to go ahead a little. See the boar rider, alright. I should go ahead, but this blocks us a little, so why don't we try to shoot this one? Alright, this is a 15 damage, that was nice. Yes, this is cause a charge, but we got some nasty retaliation. For this one, they not really retaliating, just dying. Let's see if we can shoot this one. This is not much damage. So what should we do? I cannot block this way, so this boar rider should go this way. If I go here and shoot from here, that's cause a block here, so that's not very nice. Or we just use this to, oh no, too far away, because this is an injured unit, so I thought this may be, accidentally doing the wrong thing. I don't care. So I charged it and flanked it. So let's see what we should use. I think I go with here and try to finish this unit off. So let's go here and ask them what they want to do. Yes, this is a nice one. I don't want to finish them off right now, so I just shoot at them. Oh, they got some breathing effect, so they died on us. Sorry. Okay, so that was our first battle. I truly recommend use as many skill as possible, because every skill you use, every attack you achieve, they got you XP and keep the enemy alive while you can, so you got some more XP possibilities around. Alright, I think that was our little video today. I hope you enjoyed it, and as always, thank you for watching.